how anxious are you for the upcoming season? Are you excited? Do you feel like you're going to soak in everything just a little bit more because you didn't have it for a year? What's kind of your feelings right now going into the 2021 season?
Yeah, it feels like everything's going by very quickly. Like there's already not enough time to try to get everything in. Having not seen anybody in so long now, you know, the returners, not as difficult, but with the incoming freshmen, it certainly feels like, you know, a lot of the sophomores went to 4 years and finished some more classes and transferred out and did all that. So a little less returning leadership. And so that portion of it, so cultivating younger leaders and the culture and trying to get everything in and trying to do it all in 6 weeks over this summer has been, you know, pretty difficult. So we're not where we want to be at yet, but you know, there's that hump that you get over and then you'll be ready to go. So hopefully we get over that sooner than later.
You know, that's a lot of time to just, you know, kind of be in your own head thinking about, you know, how are we going to get better for when we actually do get on the field?
Yeah. Changed the playbook several times, just the design of it. But the actual playbook has gotten its biggest revamp really ever. So working with psychologists at UCLA and how we use our terminology, how we use our the words that we use, trying to be more efficient, having, you know, carrying more meaning, trying to do a lot more with a lot less in terms of how many plays do you really need to do this or to do that. And so we found some very special things. And then, you know, the analytics revolution, you know, has been something that's been brewing. I have all my post-its on the wall in front of me and everything all over the place. So hopefully we have some weapons of mass calculation we can use to get, you know, a couple extra inches here and there. That'd be nice. But whatever we can do to put players in the best position possible is kind of what I've been brooding about in the home office for what feels like almost 2 years here. So, so yeah, very excited.
Weapons of mass calculation. Did I hear that correctly?
You did. That's original for me. So if you're repeating it, hopefully it's good and we're not, yeah, we'll see.
Coach, I know you are a numbers guy, but at some point do you just do the eyeball test and you're like, that guy can play. He's completing 76% of his passes. Absolutely. On third down. I don't need to look at that number. I know he's going to make that play when we need him to. Like at some point do you just kind of take both into consideration, the numbers and just what your gut says, what your eyes say?
Yeah, I think we use the numbers to discard fallacies. Like, you know, this guy's passing for 80%, but you know, he's never thrown a ball past the line of scrimmage. Something like that. So we'll use it to certainly help with that in recruiting or talent identification. But really we want the numbers to give us, to inform our decisions and to tell us why. So why is this happening, or why are we having success, or why are we having difficulties with this? But that goes all the way down to the player level. So the analytics that we've created are really there for player development. Most people want to use them for drafting models or things like that, but we want to use them to make players better and to guide us and to track progress and to see how those things are going. So give us, give us a peek into why players are good, not just if they're good, because at our level, we really have to develop in order for them to move on. So you come from high school and you were awesome in high school, but for whatever reason you landed with us. So we certainly need some more development, and we need to provide something for that student athlete that they weren't able to get, or something that they, something they couldn't understand. So when we can get something on paper and say, hey, you're not getting open because of this or because of that, and have something to point to, then we have a new tool that we, or a new analytic that we can look at for that player, and he can say, how well am I doing? Instead of just yards, right? So average catch, you know, you have one for 99 and now you have a huge, you know, huge average. So some of the simple statistics are fantastic, but without having large amounts of data, then sometimes they mislead you. So we just use it for some of those things and just try to simplify it down to, hey, you need to be a little bit further outside, as opposed to, you know, shouting, you know, numbers on the field and stuff like that. So we just find some reasons and then put it into human language and put it with it.
Can you talk about what this schedule is going to look like? And this could be the best schedule the Wolverines has seen, since at least since you've been there.
Yeah, I would say certainly all the teams that we have, if nothing else, have at least historically provided more depth. And that's not something that just helps throughout the course of a game, but certainly throughout the course of a season. So it's you know, it's like a playing somebody else and where they're playing a tag team match, and when they're tired, they just, you know, tag in the next guy. And you know, so that takes a toll throughout the season. But with us, you know, we have some numbers, we have some depth, we have some talent at a lot of positions. And although we're young, I'm not sure that's unique to just us this upcoming season. So we'll really have to see. You know, we've had years where we didn't think we were that good and went undefeated and won national championships, and years where we're like, we're the best team ever and have gone, you know, and have lost, you know, multiple games. So it all depends on how the talent is spread out, and with everything and how it's all shaking out at the 4 years and players coming back, not coming back, the portal, the transfer portal is different. So the distribution of those players is different than it was before. And then as well with local talent. So we'll just see where that's at. And, you know, that's why we play the season.
What is this roster going to kind of look like? And maybe is it kind of different from years past because of COVID?
Yeah, it's certainly an older roster. And so, which is, again, for me, quite a bit unique to have that many guys that are in their 20s, you know, 20 or 21, because if they come out of high school and maybe they're one of the older guys that come out and they gray shirt and they red shirt, and then COVID happens and now they're a true freshman or a red shirt freshman at 21 years old. And then somebody just graduated, you know, a month and a half ago, and you have that difference. You know, you basically have a college senior, but they have the same amount of playing experience. So it is certainly different to have some guys that are a couple years older. I think that those couple years make a big difference, and if nothing else, their disposition. Talking to those guys and talking to your 17-year-olds. Is a lot different, certainly just in casual conversation. So it's almost like a different generation. There's a big split there. So, but those older guys have been fantastic in terms of, getting the young guys, squared away in terms of, you know, get pen and paper. We do meetings here and we meet a lot, and, being accountable, things like that. Those older guys have been waiting around so long and working, working in secret to stay in shape and do all those things. So it means quite an extra bit to them. So for those guys, I think it will be sweeter to have, you know, successful seasons and sign their scholarship and finally get a chance to go, having taken every class that's available at a junior college. I think they're ready.